It's bears its soul, its innards, and you will see characters of the kind that only an insider and a person who emerges from the place can. And it's not a place that, I mean, often outsiders write about Bombay, and often they write about it in, I don't know, in many one-sided ways. But here's a book about Mumbai from a and it depicts Mumbai, and I think in later years, you know, when you talk about, because books often represent cities, so I mean, this is would be one of the books when you talk about Mumbai, and which, you know, I mean, represented as an ode to a city which I love, and I've often tried to capture in my films. It's wonderful, and I wish you all the best, and all the people sitting up there, please read. I mean, it's great to read books, and please read this book and buy it. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I've just been told that I forgot to thank two very important individuals, Justin and Uday, who spent a lot of effort. The song was theirs. And again, Justin and Uday, thank you very much for putting all your efforts and doing it. And please come here. And just take a bow for putting in all your efforts without one paisa. Thank you very much. They just believe in the journey with their friends. So thank you.
I'd like to thank Piyush for making us part of this wonderful experience. I think in this country, this is the first time that music is made for Nolan. And congratulations, Piyush.
Cheers, thank you. And now for my friend Krishna Hegde. Everybody knows him as the MLA from Vilipalli, but I know him as, hey Krishna! Well, because he's my college friend. Nobody else dare call him that. So thank you very much, Krishna, to come here.
Piyush and me are friends for 27 years. And we used to have the same cutting chai and samosa in the Mithibai canteen. And I must tell you a little story of us. Piyush was very enterprising even in college. But I won't spill all the secrets here. Both of us started our political careers together. And I used to be the general secretary of Mithibai College. Piyush used to contest the university representative. And both used to work as a team and win the elections there. We were in the same class and shared the same bench. After some time, he got into politics and I got into media. And I was part of directing plays and fashion shows. And Piyush became the general secretary of the university. After some time, we swapped roles. I got into politics and he got into films. Today, if we continued, he would have been an MLA. And I would have been a director and writer. But Piyush, I really wish you the best. You've done very well in whatever you've gone through. And we are all with you. John, Sudhir, Piyush have all campaigned in my last election and saw that I won. And while I was reading this book of Piyush, like Ekta said, it was a very racy book. Both of us know what elections were and what Gundagiri used to happen in college. And after that, I think elections were banned in Mumbai. And I was wondering whether Piyush got his inspiration from all that. Piyush, what I read about this, I'm sure you want to make a film on this. Why don't you give us your thoughts?
That's the idea. You know, I decided that I'll go the other way around. Once we write the book, nobody can steal the rights from us, right? They'll have to buy it. So, we own it, and after that we make the movie. So the journey goes, today a filmmaker cannot be just a filmmaker, he has to be a storyteller. So today I'm talking to, I'm going to be like my friend Nilesh Mishra, who has given such a lovely example of how a storyteller can engage with people on radio. Nilesh, where are you? Nilesh is somewhere there. Thank you, Nilesh, for being here. Nilesh Mishra is the writer of Ek Tha Tiger, please. 200 crores, please. And he also does a show called Yaad Shahar. So he's given us an example of how we can take a story and we can use different mediums to tell it. He tells it on radio. I tell it in a book. I tell it in a movie. What's the difference? It's a story. It takes different forms, but the story stays. And that's what my journey is. I'm going to explore it in different ways. So today it's a book. tomorrow's going to be a film. Maybe I'm going to, and I'm soon going to do it on radio too. Thanks to Nilesh's prodding. But thank you very much. I think that's why I made the sure that the story is going to be, you know, possible to adapt in different ways.
Thank you so very much, Piyush.
I would like to, you know, engage everybody who's over here into a conversation. And our idea is today to talk about crime, fiction and Mumbai. And who better than to start asking a question from? John Matthew Martin, the director of Sarfarosh, is with us. Another dear friend, John, please take a bow. His film Sarfarosh is perhaps one of the most interesting films, crime thrillers, that I love. And he happens to be a dear friend. John, when you talk about Mumbai and crime, what comes into your head? It's a question I've always thought of. You're a Mumbaikar. You are, although you know you are a Malayali from your origin, but you're from Mumbai. So you understand it like anybody else, like me. You know. So what comes into your head when you think about crime in Mumbai?
I think every Mumbaikar who has stepped into a train, a local train, guards his wallet like it's his life. And that is the first thing that you learn if you step into a train, that you want to take care of yourself. So that street, I mean, you learn to be street smart and you learn the value of what you have and to possess it. That was my first lesson for crime. But I never got pickpocketed, ever.
That's a difficult one, getting pickpocketed. It always happens. Some whoever has traveled by train has at least once felt that he's going to get pickpocketed. My bag got slashed once in train. I lost a lot of money. Anyway, now I want to ask Ekta. Ekta has been making these crime films. I mean, she makes comedies and other kind of films also. But recently, she's made a spate of crime films. Once Upon a Time in Mumbai. Now she's making Once Upon a Time in Mumbai 2. And Shootout in Wadala. She's co-producer on that. And of course, Love, Sex and Dhoka. Anshuman Jha is over here, one of the stars of Love, Sex and Dhoka. Where's Anshuman? Hi Anshuman, thank you for coming. So I want to ask Ekta, what do you think about crime when you think about crime in Mumbai? How do you balance it? I know, see, the whole thing, I feel, and if I'm asking you this, is because crime and gangsters and encounter cops, they're there always in a Mumbai crime film. Do you think it's time that some other kind of crime is also shown?
Absolutely. Like I told you that after doing Wadala and doing Once Upon a Time series, I was looking at giving another dimension to Mumbai crime. The visuals you always get because of the various pattern of films, mine and others, Ram Gopal Varma's also, is that you see a certain kind of crime in Mumbai, which is your gangsters, which is your encounter cops, which is your the underbelly, which today maybe has taken in the shape of, as we've all heard, various forms of terrorism, and most of these stories come from the 80s. So what is the crime of today? Could it be fictionalized and have various incidences made into a great fiction story? And I think, there was a question constantly asked and you came up with this beautiful book, which actually answered a lot of our questions, how to make I've never seen a glamorous train novel. You know, we've heard the train novels are the most, I think, exciting page-turner novels. We've not had one of Bombay because, you know, most of them are for the small towns and they're made for the small towns.